and summer activities in Texas. Camping is a great way to enjoy the outdoors, but there are several safety tips campers should remember. Keep watch on children. You're responsible for the safety of your child, so make sure you know where they are and what they are doing. Keep a safe distance from wild animals. They can carry diseases and be aggressive. Never feed the wild ones. Feeding wildlife can encourage bad behavior and is against park regulations. Never leave campsites unattended and always make sure it is out before breaking camp. This can lead to forest fires during the dry summer months. And some streets in Jungle Palooza combine this weekend to bring the community together with food and fun. And some streets is the perfect event for food lovers and will take place on the streets of historic downtown Hurstville. 12th Street and University Avenue will be a line of food trucks of all varieties, and is bound to have something for all tastes. Eats on the Streets will be held on the fourth Saturday of every month from July to October from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. Film students and faculty at Sam Houston State University now have two libraries which will study the arts and sciences as well as some picture production. The Department of Mass Communication recently received a DVD collection of about 200 films and TV shows valued nearly $3,900. Lane Fortenberry says the collection will provide a more centralized source for film students to study their craft. The collection is donated by Francie Neely, attorney and founding chair of the Houston Cinema Arts Society. Sam Houston State University's musical theater program recently completed in Washington, D.C. One notable student was Dominic Pesacons, who won a National Theater Musical Festival Award. Pesacons competed with representatives from 9 regions across the country. The award has given him a full-ride scholarship to the Open Jump Summer Institute in New York City. The scholarship includes all classes, meals, tickets before Broadway shows, airfare, and hotel. At the Institute, Pesacons will have the opportunity to connect with Broadway community. He will have a chance to work with one-on-one with various members of the Broadway production team. He will be living and working in Oregon this summer to help save money to move to New York. Head coach Casey Keeler and the football staff are evaluating high school football campers at Brewer Stadium. A few weeks ago, on June 3rd, was the first camp, and the next one will be July 22nd at 11 a.m. The walk-up cost is $55, and pre-registration is $45, which is open until July 8th. Only grades 9 through 12 will be accepted. Campers must bring tennis cleats, gym shorts, t-shirts, socks, and athletic support. Athletes under 18 need to have a parent or guardian sign their release before participating. Meals will not be provided, so the campers should plan accordingly to that. SHSU coaching staff will scout how it can work with each kid's hands-on. Coaches from FBC, FCS, and Division II schools were in attendance at the first camp. The second camp in July should expect the same from college coaches making an appearance. I hope everyone is prepared for this weekend as we have thunderstorms headed to Hillsville. Taking a look outside, it's currently 80 degrees, but it feels like 85 degrees. The humidity is up 81% with winds coming from the northwest. The sky is mostly cloudy with a 70% chance of rain. For today, we will reach a low of 71 degrees with cloudy skies and a 20% chance of rain around midnight. Coming up in the forecast today, the UV index is green. But for this weekend, we will have an average of 8 out of 10. People are expected to grab an umbrella and make sure to drive safe on the wet road. This weekend is expected to have a steady chance of scattered storms, and Sunday will be mostly cloudy with a 40% chance of showers and thunderstorms. Let's take a look at the 7-day forecast. The Bearcat Orientation Program is expecting FHSU students to attend an introduction session today and tomorrow. This will be the first ever introduction session for these students and their families. This session helps all new FHSU students into a smooth transition from high school to college. Students will get knowledge and collaborate services and help with members of the FHSU community. University offices and departments will also have a partnership with this program. This skills and information is a positive program for long-term academic success. That is all the time we have for today. Thank you for joining us.